Gentlemen, good evening and welcome to the 10th running of the Breeders' Crown. It's 10 years ago, nearly to the day, since David Wilson, who devised the Breeders' Crown system, had the first running at York, and the last couple have been at Tier Prince. I think it might be the third running at Tier Prince, and it was an overwhelming success last year, and let's hope it's an overwhelming success again tonight. There's a good crowd in for it. There's a lot of good racing coming up, and we'd like to thank David, also Tier Prince, for being allowing us to have the Breeders' Crown on this circuit. I've got to say the Breeders' Crown has grown a lot since the first running of it 10 years ago. There's a lot more two-year-olds around now, there's a lot more quality around now, but I guess that's how life is these days. But have a good night, and we'll be back with some interviews during the night.
So we're about to show up for each round, the first heat of three referees. So each Tyler at one, Infant Camden two, Tyler with Joy three, Springhill Alley four, and Natalie Camden is in five. All the races tonight over 1 mile. And Scar just turning her head around on the inside of Imogen Camden. Here they come for us, the 12 races on Breeders' Crown night. Looking good. There we are. Big Hill Alley's up for a good start. For a barrier of four. Holding the inside first was Reed Scarlett as they go into the first turn. Reed Scarlett taken off the lead by Tyler of Jordan on the right outside Spring Hill Alley. And they're now about to go down the back. Reed Scarlett holds his position and leads by about a half length. Tyler of Jordan is in second. Ibn Camden settles down in third against the pace. Another length away, Springhill Alley, Natalie Camden is the one whipping them in. They go for the first quarter of a mile, and Reed Scarlett in front by about a neck for the parked out Tyler of Joy. Half a minute exactly for the first quarter of a mile. Just in behind the leaders is Imogen Camden and Willie Greenhall, who just shades Dexter Dunn in Springhill Alley, and Natalie Camden wags the tail of the field. 5/8 of a mile still to go, we're about to turn in. Reed Scarlett in pole position from Tyler of Joy. Up along the pegs in behind, getting the cover, is Imogen Camden. Just behind the leading bunch, Springhill Alley, was alongside Natalie Camden, and he could cover his heels with a large 3-neck issue. They're at halfway, 1.6 to the half, and it's Reed Scarlett, the leader. Tyler Wood Joy to the outside, Imogen Camden to the peg, Natalie Camden, Springhill Alley, those two are shaking hands for last place, and they've got 3/8 of a mile still to go, and Mick Lewis controls the tempo. He's in the cockpit with Reed Scarlett, who's being followed to the outside by Tyler Wood Joy and Andrew Cairns, and Tyler Wood Joy now looking out to Imogen Camden for second place. Reed Scarlett now takes a couple of lengths out of the field. Inside the final quarter, Reed Scarlett the leader, back in second place. Imogen Camden, Natalie Camden getting a run through for Alan Hayford. Great, needs the gaps to open. An eighth of a mile to go. Reed Scarlett by a length and a half being followed by Imogen Camden and Natalie Camden. They kick the rope and Tyler will join Springhill Alley. Reed Scarlett's made every yard of the running. On the outside, Imogen Camden up against the peg, Natalie Camden. Reed Scarlett in pole position. Natalie Camden driving over the inside. Can't get there. Reed Scarlett from the front track. Reed Scarlett the winner, Natalie Camden second, back in third, Imogen Camden, Springhill Alley in fourth, and Tyler of Joy was the last to clock in. Open race of the night, the first heat of the Breeders' Crown, for these has gone the way of Reed Scarlett in the hands of Mick Law. That performance from the front for supporters of Reed Scarlett, and was a good run, Mick Deskeen from the front. Off of the final turn. Natalie Camden charged up the inside, but this is one for AC Hall. It is one of AC Hall. Reed Scarlett takes out race one. So, ladies and gentlemen, there's a big hand, please, so if you're around with us and go for our first race winner, Reed Scarlett.
Have with me David Reed, the obviously owner and breeder David, so you've got the double dose, and what a great way to win your name.
Yeah, thanks. We got there. It's been a long way, but we got there. We've got a win.
Was it a good win? Now you've got to come back again later. How do you think
the second half of the night? Yeah, I hope so. It's been a good time. We just have to involve for is make sure I can hold my breath.
Does the breeding go back far? I mean, have you had the family and others out of the family?
We got a mare out of New Zealand, which is called the Big Bruce Mine, which we bred. That was out of the Anti Prestige, which is a mare I bought out of Maristow. So, just recently, some of the new captured families are
all good. Well done, mate, and we hope you're back here later in the night as perhaps the winner of the Breeders Grand Final.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Here they come. The second heat of the Breeders' Crown three-run filly. Star holds them. And they are. Reese Jen after a pretty good start. Elsa Camden up along the inside. Reese Jen, Elsa Camden, Gabriella Camden, and Christo Jenner is last of the four sets as they go to the back. Reese Jeff is playing plenty of toes of the gate, he's in front, he puts it over his right shoulder, she's moving into Gabriella Camden, now applying pressure, Gabriella Camden coming through to take on Reese Jeff for the lead, and goes on. Gabriella Camden puts it over to number two, Reese Jeff, back in third is Elsa Camden, and then Christo Jenner. 28-5, the opening quarter, so it is considerably quicker than the first heat. Heading away from the back and his last season's Tour of Fleet champion, Gabriella Camden in front by a length and a half. Reese Jem in second position, getting a toe from the front pair is Elsa Camden and last of all Christo Jenner. And in perfect sync here down the straight in Indian file and it is Gabriella Camden the leader. Gabriella Camden now extending that advantage to around 2 lengths as they hit the halfway mark. 1.3 to the half. Gabriella Camden round the bend. Reese Jem second place. Followed by Elsa Camden, Willie Greenhorn third. And last of fourth is Christo Jenner and Gary Dowd. 3/8 of a mile to go. And Gabriella Camden continues to lead by a length and a half. With Reese Jem and Steve Lee. And a length and a half away is Elsa Camden. Who's about Christo Jenner. And they've got 1/4 mile left to face. And pointing a third in front is Gabriella Camden from Reese Jem. Gabriella Camden by 1.5 lengths, and now Reed Jem moves off the pegs for Steve Lees and gives Gabriella Camden the stare, and now Reed Jem takes over with an 8 of a mile to go. Reed Jem quickly goes a couple of lengths or so clear. Gabriella Camden in second place, Elsa Camden third, and Christo Jenner last of the four, and down the straight it is Reed Jem and Steve Lees with a conquer advantage of about 5 lengths over the pursuers. They are Elsa Camden and Gabriella Camden, but Reed Jem with a brilliant tail going on the way. Reed Jem the easy winner. Tight places between Gabriella Camden and Elsa Camden and their clear of Christo Jenner. So Reed Jem goes on to win. Steve Lees in the sulky. This will each show really good show from the gate. Lost the advantage to that first quarter of a mile to Gabriella Camden. Steve then sat in behind with Reed Jem. Pants in the back straight. Reed Jem is going to win and has won really decisively. Reed Jem by 8 of CPR is the winner of the second heat for the filly. And it's so far a very good night for Hazy Hall.
Yeah,
hopefully.
And you are too, mate. You're
We're going up for race three, the final, first final for the two-year-old Colts and Geldings. Here they come for the third race. Donna Holden, they're off. Holden was away smartly on his team out of Johnny Camden as they look into the first turn. Holden Earl, Johnny Camden, and they're being followed on that first bend by G.D.'s Hazard, who's a couple of lengths to good. Lady with Express and Coffee Mate is at the back. Next to them quickly takes Johnny Camden to the head of the race. Johnny Camden moves on now by a couple of lengths, chased by Holden Earl. Another couple of lengths to G.D.'s Hazard, who settles down in third, ahead of Lady with Express and Coffee Mate. 29-5 in the opening quarter, and it is the world champion Dexter Byrne and Johnny Camden in front by two lengths, followed by Colford Earl and Joseph Moore. Another couple of lengths to Andrew Cairns, the sixth there in third with G.D.'s Hazard. Willie Greenhorn and Ladywood Express follow, and last of all is Coffee Mate and Vicky Gill. Indian file down towards the judge and halfway. Johnny Camden controls it by a length and a bit to Colford Earl. Another couple of lengths to G.D.'s Hazard, followed by Ladywood Express and Coffee Mate now makes the move. 1-2.2 to the half, and it is Johnny Camden in front of Colford Earl. No change there, G.D.'s Hazard is behind. Coffee Mate the first to make a move. Coffee Mate is now moving to fourth. After work to get closer, and down the back, last of all, is Ladywood Express. They go on down the back with an excess of a quarter mile to pace, and Dexter's controlling things with Johnny Camden, leads by a couple of lengths now to Joseph Moore and Colford Earl. G.D.'s Hazard taken off the first by Coffee Mate, and last of all is Ladywood Express. So Johnny Camden the leader with over an extra mile to go, and Dexter's ticking away at Johnny Camden to try and extend. Johnny Camden with Colford Earl still on the case, a gap there of a couple of lengths to G.D.'s Hazard. Coffee Mate is capitulated, then Ladywood Express, and they're down the straight, and it's Johnny Camden, chased hard by Colford Earl. Johnny Camden by about two lengths, trying hard down the outside, it's Colford Earl, but this is one for the world champion, Dexter Byrne, and Johnny Camden go on to win. Second place goes to Colford Earl, right third, G.D.'s Hazard just in front of Ladywood Express, and Coffee Mate, the last one in. Johnny Camden has won it. Dexter Byrne, the world champion driver from New Zealand. He changed things for Johnny Camden, took over around that first turn to plenty or so, and then he's taking the fraction for the remainder of the race. Johnny Camden is the first champion of the night. Johnny Camden wins the first final. He's won for the 2-year-old Colton Kelly, and Johnny Camden is a whole threat by the cancer.
Dexter Dunn, ladies and gentlemen, champion New Zealand arrangement. just keeps breaking records, current world champion driver, won the World Driving Championships about 8 months ago, something like that, Dexter. And your first visit to Newfoundland?
Yeah, that's right, obviously made over Ivan last year, and talking to the boys over here, and I'm going to come here as well, obviously, over this week, so there's no hesitation in saying yes, because I had a great time last time, and already had a great time.
It seems to be the thing now, a lot of people just want to stay home and drive a lot of wheels, which you've been doing for a long, long time. Anthony Butt, one of our friends who was over in Ireland a couple of years ago, he loves travelling the world with the industry, and I think you're basically following those footsteps now.
Yeah, well, it's probably a great thing about the industry, you know, travel so much and meet so many different great people. So, I've been pretty lucky with the travel around, and, really excited about doing that.
You started very early. I think you won a New Zealand driving premiership when you were a junior driver.
Yeah, I think I was 17 or 18, so it seems like a long time ago now, but I'm lucky I get to drive a little bit home, and it makes all the difference to it.
Well, we saw you were just killing an island last year, and you've basically done it tonight. Have you got any more drives tonight?
I think I've got a few there. I think most of the races getting to drive it, so yeah, it's a good start. Hopefully we can continue.
Well, I might ask you what you like, but you're going to have to ask them first. Well done, Dexter. Hope to see you again before the night's out.
Thanks, Archie.
Dexter Dunn, ladies and gentlemen. Dexter Dunn, ladies and gentlemen.
So they're behind the starter's car now. Here they come. Is our league champion. The 3, 4 from 2, and 4 from 4, 31 share of smile. 2nd and 3, Reed Rockstar. 3 from 2, Reed Decoy. And 4 from 4, no breaks. This is our winning order, 2 minutes 04.2. 2 minutes 04.2. The distances for the 4th race, 1 length and 2.5 length. 1 length and 2.5 length. Ladies and gentlemen, a big hand for share of smile. And their first race, the three hour came from Wales, and since go to the international flight, this time comes from Scotland. Here, Mingus. Is Mingus, it's called Mingus in Scotland, isn't it?
Yes, Mingus is correct.
Yeah, we had actually had an Australian Prime Minister to talk to Robert Gordon Menzies, and when I, they used to call him Ming, I never quite worked out how that happened, but that's the Scottish ancestry. Congratulations, Cheryl. It was a terrific win. She hasn't done that much. The racing is only up for 3 runs. Good run here last time, and I did notice that there was a position that had a risk with him.
Yeah,
he's
got
it
up to
Steve
for the next reveal for the last couple of starts.
We've got a better draw today, we've got more way quicker, and got the front end, so made all the difference.
30 years ago, I made my first visit to Scotland and met Hamish. We were at the train, and today we see him in a good race. He's won a lot of good races this time, but he keeps putting plenty of money in the industry, so I guess he's entitled to get money back.
Yeah, if you hand me a pocket, you hope to get something back. It's never a guarantee, but you do hope that so far it's worked okay.
Well done, mate. Good to see Scotland winning a Breeders' Crown race. Of course, it was put on by a Scotsman, and he's still doing his daily
work. Yeah, yeah. Thank you very much, Peter Wilson.
You mean to say, gentlemen.
So, we're back to Rick and I here. In 1, Ringo Starr. 2, Colvin Honey. In 3, Victoria Camden. 4 is the Boots Fury. And 5, Fortuna. Scoring up the race tie.
Guys, look it! Go this way!
Middle Star. Just getting a little edgy there. At the inside. Here they come. Victoria Camden is holding Colford Honey. Victoria Camden makes all. Victoria Camden goes on to win. starting. Victoria Campbell starts to win, and Grant Cullen in the sulky for Victoria Campbell. This one's going to be also drink by Grant Cullen. Victoria Campbell, the daughter of Mike Pantapar, has set away nicely for Barry Free as they all the running. Ultimately, it will be only three to go with Victoria Campbell. He may race with it down the straight. Not going to fight at all. So Victoria Campbell there, holding in second place. Third place, fourth number three, second number two, third number five, fourth number four. Third number three, Victoria Campbell, second number two, Colby Hay, third was number five, Paul Delight, fourth number four, Blue Fury, and fifth number one is a real star. The triple title of the horse there, 2 minutes. 0.4.9. 2 minutes, 0.4.9.
They go on down the back and it's born to run.
still showing away the reason you see. First of all, the reason you see, the field is waiting through you, and then turn it down easy. It's by the final quarter. Now, reason you see is putting in the ball to run. It is ball to run. In front by a length, Biggie Gill is working on reason you see to close and challenge. Ball to run still in front. 8 of a mile to go. James Hathorn-Quake shakes the reins from leader Born to Run. Reeds Misty throws the gauntlet down, and they're down the straight. Born to Run, and Reeds Misty can reach the seat to the outside. Born to Run to the inside. He's deep. He's Born to Run. Reeds Misty just in front. Reeds Misty now on top. Reeds Misty turns again. Born to Run second place on a blinder. Back in third with Reeds Misty. And he's in there for Chinatown. Do you think? And Reeds Misty has gone to win and remains unbeaten to see. That's four.
Around the first turn, the ladies' love gym is the pace setter.
Three hills available in second, and Cross Hill Aces Park out as they go into the back straight on the wide outside. Cross Hill Aces Park comes in behind. So down the far side they go. The leader by a good 3.5 lengths is the lady in first place. Three hills available holding second place and Rick Lord, and Cross Hill Aces is at the back of the three. 29 seconds flat to opening quarter. The leader by a good 3 lengths is Andrew Cairns and the lady Love Jim. Followed by Green Hills Available and Nick Lord with Steve Lee and Cross Hill Ace whipping in the field and wagging the tail as they turn in. So down the straight, with a few lengths advantage on them, is the Ladies Love Jim. The Ladies Love Jim are followed by Green Hills Available and Cross Hill Ace still at the back and about to hit the half mile peg. The leading margin is a length and a half for the Ladies Love Jim, 1 minute, 1.6 to the half. Green Hills Available back in second, and Cross Hill Ace is at the back of the three. And as they go now into the far side. So it is the Ladies Love Jim, Andrew Cairns, the one is taking things here, and it's pretty careful here at the halfway marker. It is still the Ladies Love Jim from Green Hills Available, and Cross Hill Ace at the back. With 4 miles left to go, the Ladies Love Jim with a leader length and a half over Green Hills Available, Cross Hill Ace back in behind them, so it's Cairns, Lord, Lee coming towards the final eighth of a mile, and it is the Ladies Love Jim taken on the lead now by Green Hills Available and Cross Hill Ace will have to challenge on the wide outside. So down the straight they come, and Green Hills Available really putting it to the Ladies Love Jim, who goes the shortest way, and here comes Cross Hill Ace down the outside. Green Hills Available's got the lead. Cross Hill Ace finishing off really well. Green Hills Available and Cross Hill Ace. Green Hills Available speeding it out, and a good match of Cross Hill Ace. Green Hills Available winner, Cross Hill Ace second, and the Ladies Love Jim drop the bird.
Yeah,
things.
Absolutely, and after all, it was the Breeders' Crown.
Yes, yeah, and he would eventually be a
man of Western Britain. Mate, we've got a lot of Australians here tonight, and the reason I was late down, actually, Darren said I was at the bar, but I was just a little bit beyond the bar, and I ran into David Morton, and I was asking about Mr. Stanley Rich Mystery. Now, he's got a very good chance of winning the Cup of Gold in a couple of weeks' time. Especially the open draw, he's not going to have the contemporary handicap draw, but also Australians are going to be at Corby Wood next weekend and he's going to be running on Saturday.
Yes, he is, he's also running on Saturday. And there's a free throw out on Saturday, he's in that. He's in the big ones on Saturday. Yeah. We scored him when he came back from here last week. He scored that. He wasn't clean, he was running all right, but he wasn't clean.
Well, if he wasn't 100% real life, something would have been because he had to come up to way back in the year for a long time.
Yes, he did. He's still in there for a while. He's got to get him. He's
They're getting better all the time, and you're sort of got a horse as he's got on. That must be true in the year.
Well, no, he isn't. And of course, it seems as well as getting older. We don't just feel as good in the morning as we used to do.
Absolutely, especially when we do like what I do and come on those tours and that sort of stuff. Just before I let you go, I think I posted a picture on Facebook of you and Lance Jarvis together at a World Driving Championship. Lance, of course, was our living legend in Australia this year. And then, lo and behold, looking through some of the photos, and there's you and Lance.
Yeah, we're called up in America at the World Driving Championship. And we seem to get some of these people around the world. Yeah. I don't really speak for that because it's a part of it. I think it's a record. It's a part of me and he's going out and he's in our place. So we don't speak that much, but I would like to speak more, yeah.
Well, he's had some great old free-for-alls, you know, smoking up as a superstar, and much the same as yourself, you know, with history. I mean, you could try to good old horse to keep it going.
Yeah, I must admit, I used to watch last week. I think Mystery was maybe his contemporary in this country. Was it 4 million or 5 million?
Something like that, mate. He was a superstar at his time. I think he glanced probably might follow another soap goal that's nearly as good before him. He's not, he can't have it forever. And he's got a good one at the moment, so I'm sure he'll bounce back. And you've sort of a few nice ones in Australia.
Yeah.
Congratulations, mate. And I hope you're probably one of the favourites in this country.
No.
I'm getting confused.
We've got
the two from the next, and Tess done. Right, well, give him a drive, mate. He does do it
pretty well. Yeah.
Thanks, mate.
Thanks, ladies and gentlemen. They've got the score up for Race 8. 21, No 72, Air Trooper, and 3, Miraculous. Here they come. And the white flag is. They're off. And the Miraculous goes straight into the lead. He's in familiar territory. In control around the first turn. Miraculous leader. Air Trooper second. And no stopping last of the trio. Already fairly well spaced out. Patrick Kane on this Breeders' Crown mission, sitting behind Miraculous. Second place held by Dexter Dunn with the Shield All Train Air Trooper and no stopping in a few lengths to catch. Through the first quarter mile, Miraculous going his pace. It's Miraculous in front. 29.7. That's rather sedate for Miraculous. It's a Maui Mountain pace. It is Miraculous 1, Air Trooper 2, and several lengths away is no stopping. 5 eighths of a mile to go, and Miraculous is in front of the approach to the turn. Dexter Dunn corners with Air Trooper, and Air Trooper is in second place ahead of no stopping. Coming up towards the half, Miraculous from Air Trooper and no stopping against the half in a time of 59.9, just short of a minute. So on their final surges, Miraculous still in front by a couple of lengths of Patrick Kane, Kentland and Air Trooper. Track Miraculous and the several lengths of Lando Soffit and Willie Greenhorn. Going on down the back straight is Miraculous from Air Trooper. The leading margin extended fractionally to about 2.5-3 lengths now. Quarter mile to go. Miraculous in front. Air Trooper second and no stopping. The maiden left behind by several lengths. Over an inch of a mile to go. And it is Miraculous continuing to pace along at his pace. He's going along merrily. He's got a smile on his face. Turning into the straight, he's 5 lengths clear. Miraculous from Air Trooper and no stopping. This is the chap. He's having a tremendous season. Miraculous is the Breeders' Crown Real Cup champion. Miraculous the winner, back in second place there, Trooper, and third is no stopping. And there's a track record that's just gone for 3 rounds. This was a smash in the pieces. Confirmation of that time, 1:56.9. 1:56.9. He did that and he just breathes a lot. But well, he really is the kingpin of the circuit. 1:56.9. The track record for all ages here at Deer Prince is 1:55.4. This was only 7 tenths outside. So I'm just saying 1:56.2 is the track record for all ages here in 1:56.2. Harvey Flower and his merry men around the track, the owners. Ladies and gentlemen, the men will be furious in that race with a decisive winner, but you are looking at, if not the finest horse on the circuit, or certainly one of the finest horses on the circuit, and with a big hand, Bob Miraculous!
Congratulations on the night, mate. Great guy and a driving great horse.
Gabriella Camden needs to close in. The scoring up. Rear of the Leeds Championship, race 9. Freak Scarlet. Really keen to get on with this job. Here they come.
Coming after the next, the left side, the top of the line, 13 miles left. And then you just try to sleep, and that's one guy. If one dude didn't run, just get the other two. But I just get the other.
The shoulder toe, but she's got lots of fakes because she's done that on Barry before. She's brought forward to start.
You shoulder fake, Lord, you
so look, she has, though, she's got lots of toe.
Yeah, she's a sharp wife. I'd rather run to see the knee than start to Barry, so she says she can
do it. You can see the that was it, and the top of the straight, you kicked again?
Yeah, she was strolling around the turn, she was strolling on the middle of the
and what you said to the boy you've had going forward after today?
I'll have a drink.
I'll have a drink. We'll love to see you.
Thanks,
Dad. There's a big for Seaweeds. Ladies and gentlemen, Seaweeds. Yeah, that's what we need there. Great performance with the regen. Brought for short tremendous toe to lift the Euro Police Division. And it picked off the final bend. And it's just left them again. There, down the straight, he's Green Sergeant in second, and he's in the cabinet in third. Well, here we go. Who was the light, Rome 1? Line 32, it's my check in 3. It's my check, we could have called 1, but ran out of the final there. Green Sergeant has been winning several races on the circuit this year. Line 20 there, in the middle seat. Pat having a really good night, he trains line 20. Excellent, look at him. Second win of the world champion. And he drives line to Premier. They screw up for the 4-year-old coach to go in his championship bike. So it's going to line in 1. Line to Premier in 2. And it's my check in 3.
Grayson.
Here they come.
Adam.
Race 10 field, the 4-year-old, the coach. Well, it's my guess to attend your show from Green Delight and Lions Treasure as they go into the first turn. It's my check is in front and adapted along by about 3 lengths. Green Delight second, Green Delight with Lions Treasure along the outside. So Alan Hinton Bridge has It's my check in front, but Dexter Dunn is taking Lions Treasure forward to the outside. It's my check. And Lions Premier,
those that don't know, well, Darren Owen, our court commentator, and great arm strike, he curses the part over of that winner, so he's quite excited about it, and rightly so too. I had great fun with not only Darren Owen but Alan Theresa Acorn quite last Christmas when they came across the Intermediate Championships, and Darren said to me a couple of weeks ago we got a chair and a horse, went away for a while, and a week and a half ago, and he won in third, so I had a bit of trouble seeing it, but I think Darren's really chuffed when I get you out there, right?
Yeah, he's probably a real Acorn horse, and Darren is chair and a horse.
Well, it's back 3 for 3 now, we're in 3-3, all winning majors tonight. See you, Lee, Chicklord, now our mate will cry.
Yeah, we're happy all day.
Good on you, mate. Well done. Darren, can you come up and have a microphone for us? Well done. Have a bit of a drill
now. Oh, great. No, that was nerve-wracking calling that, Rick.
Look at here.
I was more nervous calling that than calling 13 Grand Nationals.
Is that right?
Reed Firebird and Reed Dance,
now Grant Cullen and Lion Starlight, these two together. So it's Reed Firebird and Lion Starlight. Just in behind the front two, Red Sovereign is trying to get competitive. That one is to a peg. Here's Christo Fisk. Someone like you is having to come on the wide outside. Less than an eighth of a mile to go. Reed Firebird seems to have shaken off the intentions of Lion Starlight. Down the outside, Christo Fisk and someone like you. Here comes Christo Fisk. He's putting it to Reed Firebird. Christo Fisk, Reed Firebird, someone like you. Christo Fisk and Reed Firebird. A few lengths away, someone like you, and then a whole host of intensity will turn up on the inside line, Starlight, outright, check me out, and then after he's a great sovereign. Photo finish. Photo finish. So, finish there to a race number 11 between race title number 2, Crystal Chris, and number 8, Reed Firebird.
Photo finish on first place.
And that was to Eddie Madder. Round of applause for Eddie! He's got his bus pass!
They're straying up to the trot, the Epimadam Memorial Trot. Our final race. Here he comes. And strong.
Well done, mate.
I know it was a very emotional night for you. Congratulations. Who really does? Poor Adelaide.
Some of the friends were in the crowd. I've been at 12 races. Some really fast horses. Possibly the people on the... No, it's not possible. It's possible. We'll see you again.
There's another great thing. And I'm bringing forward the crowd here.
That concludes the 10th Breeders' Crown meeting here at Tear Prince. We'll be back next Tuesday, the 9th of August.